The following video will be about yet another missing persons case that has been turned into a true crime drama by some YouTube channels. Thankfully, not as much as some. 5 foot 350 pounds at the time of disappearance, brown hair, brown eyes, Sandra Lynn Johnson Hughes. Born 1966, July 26th, had park ranger studies from college and wilderness survival training is implied or stated. Also, the word survivalist is thrown around. Under all conditions I'm citing, no one is citing their sources, or they conflict with each other, including about how old she was, being wrong by 5 years in some cases, both directions. 2020, June, sometime, not specified, she had moved from Hawaii to California, and it's listed that she was in Hawaii for X number of time, and again, on every website, it's different. She was now in California, and she had dyed her hair blue. In that month, on the 26th, June, she talked to her family about going on a solo camping trip. She left for the Sierra National Forest and or other locations. And depending on where you get the information from, people then add in storytelling to it instead of facts. July 2nd, or a different day. Depending on where you're looking, even police agencies have different days and months for this. Usually they're off by up to 4 days each direction. On the 2nd of July, at Johnson Meadows campsite, her campsite was found. It was trashed. Belongings, quote, disheveled, scattered, and emptied carelessly. This is repeated later on. The picture of the campsite, which is much more important because that would be a factual piece of data, looks like it was torn apart by any number of animals looking for food at every other campsite I've seen where people did not secure the campsite, and it wasn't an area where animals knew to stay away from humans and tore stuff up. And or a person who was delirious from, in one case that I observed, hypothermia, tearing their tent apart trying to get something, or just frustrated. I've personally witnessed a person just simply losing their temper and tearing a tent up, both while that person and I were homeless, and also when a person was simply walking around with very expensive gear and destroyed about $2,000 worth of stuff because they were just trying to get the zipper to shut. And I have personally torn up one of my infamously cheap $30 tents because the damn thing wouldn't let go and I was just tired of dealing with it. It was a long day. I was done with it. And that was while camping and fishing, not while homeless. Next, July 4th or 5th, the following two things are either before or after and before. Again, each website has a different take on this. July 4th or 5th, she was seen near or at Chiquito Creek at the trailhead or just near it. And then various other details are thrown in, and then people start talking about various things. She was barefoot with a bruised face, described variously as having a black t-shirt and blue jeans, and no shoes or having shoes. Offered help, declined the help, hung around a few minutes and walked into the woods, but no one's saying what direction, where were they. And this has either happened before or after her car was found. It had fallen into a ravine and or been high centered on a log or just run off the road by Chiquito Creek. Both of these locations are 5 miles north of her Johnson Meadows campsite, which is not a very long distance. And again, the belongings in the vehicle were spilled out, disheveled, scattered, and emptied carelessly. Again, that indicates an animal being able to sense food contact from your hands getting on containers and whatever, ripping open containers that they do not understand, trying to find food, and or just pawing through things. Or she might have been trying to find something, again, frustratedly. It's very obviously a car accident. So we have a report before or after an accident of someone seeing her with a bruised face, and before or after the bruised face, someone finding the car. That obviously could be correct order or not, but every website gets it different. I can't find consistency. So let's assume on or about July 4th, the 12th of July, her sleeping bag was found 2.5 miles from the car by Spotted Lake in Yosemite National Park. Now at 54 years old, because her birthday had now passed, go forward another month or so, August 9th, she may have been last seen or not, east of the car location. The specific location is listed as Road 5S1, S01, excuse me, by Portuguese Overlook and or near Bayshore Road and or other wording that's even more vague. Even though that seems precise, you'd have to go look it up. She was visibly thinner, wearing overalls and a floral t-shirt, which is not what she's been described as wearing, and had no shoes, and was leaning against a tree. This is a report from a couple of hunters who saw this in an area where not having gear, in fact, not having a rifle, was risky. Not in an area where a person would have just walked out their backyard. And they drove away. This is after there was news reports, radio reports, look for a girl with blue hair, a lady with blue hair who's in her 50s. And some websites list her as being 59 years old or 48. Now, if you're not aware of the timing, that's over a month after the other incident. This could be a different person, but it's in the same general area. But finding a person, middle-aged or not, with blue hair walking around in the forest in this area would not have been impossible because this is July and August. 2021. We're talking literally a year later now. By Shut-Eye Peak, 5 miles south of her old camp area. This is a claim of somebody. Somebody brings this up as a supernatural thing. I'm going to explain it to you. A family said that their son said he saw a blue-haired woman wearing a black t-shirt and blue jeans, which matches the original report that was circulated widely that the kid probably heard or saw, lying face down, legs sticking up. But when adults approached the spot, they could not see anybody there, and there was no evidence of it. But they decided to post this on Facebook, and people are bringing this up as a sign of indigo children and Madera County Sheriff's Office, number 559-675-7770, and I hope the news agencies got that right. Conclusions. She's on a camping trip. She drove her car to where the camping area is. She didn't hike for 20 miles. She hiked for a short distance, long enough to not hear the road or not be directly next to it, parked her car, that sort of thing. The campsite was torn to bits, and she was in her car, drove a certain distance, and went off the road, and everything spilled out of it. The wreck could have caused that. She might have been pawing through it in an unstable position, trying to get her stuff out, panicking, and a head injury. As for what happened at the camp, she could have simply left camp to go get some more, go down to the local 7-Eleven to get some food. And this happened. Head injuries like this do not, I'm going to say this to you, do not cause a person to have amnesia. Looking at the subject of amnesia, let's get this out of the way. There are medically confirmable cases of this. There's literally, not just a joke, a handful, there's literally 6 to 12 maximum, period. Yeah, but true amnesia where a person can't remember anything about themselves is caused by extremely focal damage to a particular part of the brain that only happens in some of the cases, a bullet going through the skull, and in other cases, an infection due to a parasite. I don't think that would qualify in these cases. She bumped her head, got dazed and confused, and wandered off in the forest. As seen by her being offered, it probably was a wreck and she was seen right after it and they just didn't know where the car was because it was in a ravine. This is actually very common, by the way. And she was walking wounded with a head injury, frontal lobe injury probably. And she refused help. What do you do when you see someone like that? First thing you say is, were you in a car accident? I'm okay. If they don't answer yes or no, do you know if you've been in a car accident? I'm taking control of the situation. You're not leaving. You will sit down and you will not leave until the police show up. Then it's the police's fault for not calling the ambulance, but because they're legally required everywhere I know of to call an ambulance against your will. Why? If you can't answer, were you in a car wreck, or are you just wandering around, maybe barefoot because the shoes came off, out in the middle of nowhere with a head injury, where's your car? And if it's not a car, did you fall down a cliff? So let's get that done. If this happens to you and you see it, you don't care about lawsuits. You do not want to feel guilty for the rest of your life because I could have saved that person. Okay? If you see me wandering around, dazed and confused, I can't think, and I can't answer simple questions like, do you remember what happened in the last 10 minutes? If I can't answer, it could be heat prostration, poisoning, head injury. I could be dying from hypothermia. Get an ambulance. I'd rather owe a hospital a lot of money than have a morgue send a bill to my relatives, okay? Next. She told her family that she was going on a solo camping trip. She didn't take someone with her, and she didn't tell anybody her exact location, and she did not make sure she had permanent, continuous communication in the modern era. No, I don't care what you think or say, and I don't care if you scream, don't blame her. If any of your family or friends try to do this, you will say, that's nice, I'm going to be going with you. Why? Because you can't shake me, I'm going to tail you. There's you can look up a story of a guy who died in Alaska because he was overconfident of his abilities, and he died a horrible, miserable death because he kept trying to live off the land and be natural and be nature boy, and he made a tea out of something that would kill him agonizingly, and he killed himself that way. Was this person overconfident in their abilities? I don't know. Being in a car wreck in the middle of nowhere, is that something you anticipate? The answer is if you take an actual search and rescue course, you're told this is the most common way people go missing in the forest. Roads in forests are not maintained well. They roll off, and a car rolling off a cliff is not going to be visible down at the bottom. You're not going to be looking down there, number one. Number two, it's going to get covered with plants within a day or two if you have kudzu growing. As the car falls down, plant material follows after it and covers it. The most common reason people get lost and die in the forest is they twist an ankle, fall into a ravine, or their car goes off the road. This is literally a textbook example of how people die. But she didn't die. She got out of that ravine. The next reason they die is they won't accept help, or they don't realize they need it. Immediate comments below. You're blaming the victim. And my response is, shut the hell up. I've participated in trying to find someone in the forest, and myself and a 18-year veteran of search and rescue, which is really rare in the state of Oregon, he and I both had to be hauled out with twisted ankles. It happens to people who do this literally all of the time. Why would you assume it can't happen to you? Not her. Why would you? Not the kid. No. Is this an indigo kid? No. I'm going to explain it. If you're in a car and you look out the window will tint colors a different way. Shut up. It's not ghosts. Next, when you look at something unfamiliar, why would you assume the kid is like a 20-year veteran of being in the forest? You look out at a forest, you don't know what you're looking at, and your brain will try to put things together because if your brain didn't put things together, human beings wouldn't have avoided coyotes attacking them as well as jaguars. Okay, we're prey creatures until we turn into predators when we get older. It's a survival ability. You see things and you make things out of it. What they should have done is pick up the kid after checking that the woman wasn't there, brought the kid out and said, I'm going to bring you towards and I want you to keep staring until it disappears. Oh, now we're going to back up and tell me where you see it. Okay, direct my hand to the spot where the blue is. I experienced the same thing, and it was caused by the window filtering out all the colors except blue, and it was an iridescent surface on a leaf in the middle of the forest, and I thought it was a jellyfish. Because that's how iridescence works. What happened to her? She got in a car wreck, got a head injury, and wandered off. And had an opportunity at least once to be rescued. The other two viewings, when she was skinnier, and the other one from the kid, probably wasn't her. Because it probably wasn't. And that's it. What can we learn from this? If someone appears to be injured, ignore them when they say, don't help me. Thanks for watching. Have a good day. Good luck with